Welcome to Character Creation Part 2. In this episode, we're going to be looking at texturing our character. So we're going to be going through a process called UV mapping. And for anyone who's sort of unfamiliar with that term, let me just give a quick example of what it is. So imagine you have a cube that you want to texture. The easiest way to do it would be to sort of cut it along the edges such that it can unfold into a sort of 2D form. And then you can just draw on this 2D form in, say, Photoshop, for example. And then once you're done, you can just stick that image onto the object, and the computer will just sort of wrap it all up. So that's really what UV mapping is all about. With that said, let's have a look at how we actually do all of this. Okay, before we begin, let's just press N and disable background images, because we won't be needing those anymore. And we can just drag this icon in the top right corner to open up a new window, and we can set this to a UV window. And now let's go into edit mode on our character, and we'll be working mostly with the edge select tool. So I'll press Control Tab and just choose Edge Select. And now to start, let's select this whole ring of edges around the sort of beginning of the arm. You can press Control E and say Mark Seam to just sort of separate this off from the rest of the body. We'll do the same thing around the hand to separate it from the sleeve. So just Control E, Mark Seam once again. So now this whole sleeve is just sort of like a tube, really, and to unwrap it, we just need to add a single cut along the one edge. So I'll quickly do that, and we can press Control E and Mark Seam once again. And now to see how this is looking, let's just select everything with A, press U, and unwrap. And we can see that we've got a nice arm unwrapped here. And the hand is a complete mess, but we'll come back to that. Let's work on the leg quickly. So we'll select this whole sort of edge loop here that sort of separates the leg from the upper half of the body. You can just mark a seam there and do the same thing around the boot. And we can also just choose an edge to mark a seam along. And we'll unwrap that, and we've got a nice sort of trouser over here. Let's do the boot quickly. I think we can unwrap this basically as if it's just a cube. We'll just select along each of these four edges, like so. And maybe also just grab these little bits over here. Control E, Mark Seam. We can unwrap everything, see how that's looking. Okay, we've got a nice little boot shape over there. We might as well do the hand now. So this is a bit of a difficult shape, really. Thankfully, we're not going to need to put too much detail into the texture, so we can just do something rough, like select this whole ring around the thumb, and maybe just... oops, I'm selecting all sorts of things I don't want. Just select around here, mark that as a seam, and maybe this whole edge along the hand and around here, mark that as a seam, and we'll unwrap it all. So while it's not really optimal having to separate the thumb from the hand, I just wanted to keep things very simple, and for our purposes this is going to be completely okay. Let's also separate the head, so I'll just select this whole ring, Control E, mark seam, and just select everything and unwrap once again. As you can see, the jacket's unwrapping pretty nicely. Just this little bit over here at the bottom is looking a bit strange. So if we just resolve that by just marking these edges as seams and unwrap, you can see it's now, let me just toggle this, it's now unfolding quite logically along here, now that we've sort of given a cut along this edge. Okay, let's go into the hat, which at the moment is a separate object, actually. And if we just unwrap that, it'll unwrap quite okay without any seams. But one thing to think about is maybe we don't need to have as much detail in the bottom half of the hat. So we could just separate it out from the top by marking a seam all along the rim there. And now we can make the bottom half of the UV just a lot smaller and save us a bit of texture space. So let's just join this onto the body just select, shift right click to select and press Control J. And for the hair, this should just unwrap completely fine without any seams. Just like that's quite okay. Let's see, I'm just going to unwrap everything once again, just so it's all sorted out nicely. And I think at this point, let's go ahead and just apply the mirror modifier. And we can quickly maybe hide the hat. Because what I want to do is this sort of top bit of the head, all these faces along here, we're never going to see them since they're, of course, hidden by the hair. So just to save us some UV space, we can just go ahead and press X and delete all of those faces. I want to unwrap the head again now that we're no longer in mirror mode, since we might not want the texture to be symmetrical. So let's just select only the head. We can just box select this top bit and then maybe shift right click to quickly select the sort of parts of the neck that we want. Then we can press shift H to hide that. I also want to hide the hair object, so in object mode I'll just select that and press H. Going back into edit mode on the body, let's go into edge mode and just select these edges along the back of the neck. Control E, mark seam, select everything and unwrap. And that looks like a much better unwrap. We've got this sort of nice area over here for the face, if we want to add in some eyes or whatever. And let's just press Alt H to unhide everything. And the same thing in object mode. And now that the body doesn't have a mirror modifier anymore, we can just join the hair on as well. So it's now all one object. And okay, the UVs look like quite a mess over here. But if we just go into UV island mode, we can, turn off proportional editing, which is for some reason on. We can now just sort of drag this out of the way. And we've got all our UVs here. We just need to basically arrange them now so that they are all being accorded the sort of correct amount of UV space based on how detailed we want them to be. So let's just create a new image. We can just call this UV. And I'm going to change the generated type from blank to a UV grid. And just say OK. And what this means is that in the viewport, if we now press Alt Z, we can see a preview of how the UVs look. So we can determine sort of how much resolution each part of the body is being accorded based on the size of these little squares. So as you can see, if we sort of scale something up and it gets more UV space, it's got a higher resolution, we can fit more little blocks on. And we can also see if there are any problems, any UVs that are sort of completely twisted, but everything seems to be mostly okay. So let's begin arranging. I'm going to start just by dragging everything off this UV square here. And let's see, what should we start with? I'll maybe grab the jacket, straighten that, give it some space, scale it up a bit. Grab the trousers. Let's see, where should I put these? This part is very much like a jigsaw puzzle, really, just trying to give everything as much space as we possibly can. Let's grab the face, make sure that it gets enough room for detail. I'm going to scale that up quite big. The sleeves. All right, let's continue by bringing these boots in somewhere. Maybe we can... where can they go? I think I'm going to scale down the jacket a little bit. It's taking up too much space. Same thing with the sleeves, maybe. And I'll see if I can find a nice place to put the boots. Maybe in here would be good. Something like that. And let's see what's left. We've got the hands, which should go together with the little thumb. And these can be quite small. We'll just stick them in somewhere. Maybe in here will work. And grab the hair. Scale this up. And the top of the hat can make quite nice and big. And the bottom of the hat we care less about, as discussed earlier, so it can make that much smaller. And now let's just rotate around our model. That's all looking pretty good. I'm quite satisfied with the UVs. So now that we're happy with that, I'm going to close this image. And I'm going to open up a new image, which I'm going to change from UV grid to blank. And I'm going to call this our AO, which stands for ambient occlusion. And in case you don't know, what that basically is when we bake the sort of global illumination, the sort of little shadows that will appear on our character where light is occluded. So for example, in here, where the jacket's covering it up, or maybe a little bit sort of under the head, along the neck and around the hair, that sort of thing. So we can bake this by going into the render panel, and under bake, we can change the bake mode from full render to ambient occlusion. And all we have to do then is hit bake, and we wait, and you can see it's all being baked nicely here. And now if you press Alt Z, you can see exactly what that's done. Like I said, some light shadows under the sort of brim of the hat and around the hair, under the body, under the arms. It just it helps to give the character some more form and some subtle shading, and it's just a very nice thing to always do. But one problem is that if we ever want to take the character's hat off, we can see that the top of his head is just completely black. So I'm going to bake this again, but just with the hat moved off some distance. And also we can increase the quality a little bit. It's very sort of low res at the moment. So we can fix this by going into the World panel. And under Gather, we can go to Samples, and we can just turn this up to something higher, maybe 20, for example. And we'll just hit Bake again. And I'll speed this up, because it'll take a couple of seconds. Okay, so now that that's finished, we've got a nice, high-quality ambient occlusion map, and the hair is no longer completely black, so I'm going to put the hat back on his head, just like over there, and now we are ready to begin actually texturing this. So what we can do is we can export this ambient occlusion map by going onto Image, and we can say Save as Image, or F3. And I'm going to just save it as AO. And we can go into Edit Mode and just select all our UVs and go into UVs and say Export UV Layout. And I'm going to call this my character UVs. And I'll save that. And now if we just find those wherever they're saved, in my case that's Tutorials, I can't find it, Character Creation, Texturing, and I'm going to select these both and open them up in Photoshop. So what I'm going to do here is just go into my AO, and I'm going to just make sure that my color is black, and I'm just going to fill in black all around it, and I'll select everything, press Command-C to copy, go into my character UV's image, and just paste that in, and I'm going to put it on the layer below it, and I'm going to set both of these blend modes to multiply. So what I like to do is just to create a separate layer for each of the different parts, such as the head and the hat and the boots, etc., and to fill in each of them just with some color. And the reason for this is that once I finish doing that, I can just select all of the layers and press this sort of lock transparent pixels button. And that means that if I go into some layer, say for example the boots, and I want to change its color, I can just sort of brush over it without worrying about affecting any of the other parts. Alright, now to preview this texture on our model, I'm just going to save, and I'll call this something like character texture, and go back into Blender, and now under image, we can say open image and find our character texture. And straight away, we can see it previewed on our model, and we can look around, and you can see there's seems to be a spot that I've missed on the texture. Just these two faces at the back here. So if I go back into Photoshop and quickly rectify that, then I just need to save. And I go back into Blender, and under Image, we can find the Reload Image command, or we can simply press Alt-R, and you can see the texture is immediately updated. So now the rest is very straightforward. I'm just going to go back into Photoshop and paint in some simple colors for each of the different parts, and keep previewing in Blender, making sure that the colors are working nicely together on the model. And finally, we have a finished result. All right, I hope you've been enjoying the series thus far, and next time we'll be looking at rigging, so I hope to see you then. Cheers!